Lloyd Rutzky has been a vendor at Wrigley Field for 54 years. In 1970, he decided to start taking some pictures of his friends and colleagues, and now he's put them all into a new book.
Wrigley Field's Amazing Vendors is available now on paperback, and Lloyd is here now to talk about it. Good morning, Lloyd.
Morning.
Hi.
So what was it like, you know, going through some of these old photos? Was it fun to go through these photos and think of all the people you met?
It's just a, you know, very nostalgic and a very emotional to look at these things that, you know, 54 years, all these people who are, and some of them are no longer around, and you know, the prices and the uniforms we wore. It's hard to believe that actually some of this, so I think some people wouldn't believe this actually happened. Right. We looked like this, but there's the proof.
Let's take a look. Do we have some pictures we can look at here? Let's see. I don't want to assume too much that we have a segment on a, there we go.
There's one.
Look at that.
There you go.
So what did a beer go for when you were starting?
Yeah, the prices especially.
Well, when I started in 1965, beer I think was 40 cents, but I wasn't old enough to sell it until 1969, and I believe it was 45 cents or 50, it was 45 cents, I think, when I started selling beer. I mostly sold Frosty Malts, though, the first year I was eligible, 1969, to sell beer, and because a lot of items were just as pretty much as good, and
how much does success depend on the individual
That's
vendor?
A good question. Yeah.
Quite a bit.
How
I
so?
Mean, that you just have to really hustle, you know, and you have to know where you're going and what item aisles are open. That
what's the hot aisle?
And the hot aisle. And
who's spending the money?
Lots of people who are going to be thirsty or whatever product you're selling that you want to sell it. You just keep going and you don't stop.
So you talked about changes in uniforms, changes in prices. I imagine you've seen a big change in food too. You're mentoring Frosty Malts.
Yeah.
Which I haven't seen it at the baseball park.
I think they still sell them.
Do they still sell those? Okay,
I think they, but not
aisle.
The same. It was used to be in a little cup with a paper, with a plastic wooden spoon in a plastic wrapper. And they used to it was only a quarter, and you could, some people, vendors used to throw it to the fans with the spoon on the bottom. You're not allowed to throw things at
the pump. It's a very legal society we live in now. So what is the relationship like among the vendors? Is it like a fraternity, or is it more competitive?
Well, it's pretty competitive. That's one of the reasons that I've kind of enjoyed the competitiveness of it, that, you know, challenge against trying to do the most I could and beat my friends, and in a good way, and not, some people are, you know, very, this is, you know, there's money involved, so you're trying to make as much as you can, and so it's a hustle you know, as long as you can, and every opportunity that is available. And
what's a vendor mate pull down these days?
Well,
what's an average salary?
You could make, well, it's not as lucrative as it used to be. Maybe you do like $150 a game, or
a game,
a couple, maybe a little more, maybe something like that. And you know, you work 3 hours, two or three, something like that.
Yeah.
What do vendors think about the people that do not tip? I'm always wondering about that when you see some guy who doesn't, wants all the change back, doesn't leave anything for the vendor.
Doesn't bother you at all.
Doesn't bother you, just keep moving on.
What do you think of when you look at these pictures, these old pictures?
I love it. I'm so kind of very proud of it. These people that I loved, Irving Neuer and...
Irving's got a great story too.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Yeah, he was legally blind pretty much the last few years. And I mean, in the picture you're showing, that he's really not, as it looks like he could be 80 years old there, but he probably was only like 55 or 60 at that time, and but he had a, you know, the people had harder lives than I think, and these people are just, they were my friends, and some are gone, and I'm just so happy that I have these pictures to with them.
How much are you engaged in the game as a fan?
Oh, well, I watch the game. That's why I've done this so long.
Yeah.
So I could see the game.
Yeah.
And so I could always watch it's very important that you won't get hurt by foul balls or line drives or bats. I was nearly killed once by a flying bat.
Wow.
And it just bashed off the bottom of the just missed me. And so you have to pay attention. Yeah, that's me in the
Wait,
left.
Was it?
Yeah,
oh,
that
was
me. Oh, okay. I don't know if we can go back to that. But
okay, that was me. You just
Wow. There. Just as good looking now as you were then.
Yeah. Oh, that's
Look
great.
At
that's
you.
That's me on the left. That's
my friend
great. Abe, and that's Dave Klemp, and those two guys are still working, and the
still
other
there?
Guy.
That's
yeah,
great.
They're still working, yeah. And
very cool. The book is called Wrigley Field's Amazing Vendors. Lloyd, so great to talk to you.
Well, it was very nice to be here.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. And you can get the book at all the places, and there's one of the vendors who is in the book, she has a store in Evanston called Let's Tailgate. They sell it there too.
So. Oh, good. All right.
And, well, nice to
Thanks, Lloyd.
Thank you.
All
Thank
right.
you very much.
Hey, Anna.